It's that time. Today, I'm talking about computer engineering. Some questions you might have are, what is computer engineering? What topics do you learn about in a computer engineering degree? Should you take a computer engineering degree? How much money will you make? What companies do computer engineers work for? Is there demand for computer engineers? And so many more questions that I'm gonna answer today. I've covered lots of other engineering topics, so if you want to go check those out, check out this playlist after you're done watching this video, and let's get it started. So, what is computer engineering? Well, as I'm sure you might be able to guess from the name, it has something to do with computers.
Wow.
According to Wikipedia, computer engineering is a branch of engineering that integrates several fields of computer science and electronic engineering required to develop computer hardware and software. So if you've ever seen people with their big old GPUs or cool work-from-home setups or Bitcoin mining rigs, then you know that a computer engineer probably helped make some of that stuff. Computer engineers generally help the advancement of computer technology and work on improving it every single year through different consumer and business-facing products. So now that we know that computer engineers make computers,
wow.
What are the topics that you will learn in school? Well, for starters, computers would be a good bet.
Wow.
But more specifically, you'll do some basics in coding and hardware, then work your way up to more complex software and hardware communication protocols. For example, in your first 2 years, you'd learn about logic design, data structures and algorithms, microprocessors, programming, electrical engineering basics, circuits, electronics and systems, and electromagnets. Then, in your later years, you would learn about control systems, operating systems, digital systems, signals in systems, communication systems, electronics, embedded systems, computer communication networks, and internet communications, and even more. So if any of those sound like they're interesting to you, then maybe you should take a computer engineering degree. And honestly, speaking for myself, this is the first time I've actually looked at this course list, and I can't help but notice that there are some striking similarities between computer engineering and mechatronics engineering. So if your school doesn't offer mechatronics, I would recommend doing computer engineering and doing a bit of software on the side or joining a robotics team to get the whole mechatronics feel. Anyway, so back to computer engineering now. You learn a lot about computers and how they work, down to the most basic levels of logic gates, and then up to more complex things like network communications. It's actually quite interesting stuff, and I've learned quite a bit of it myself through my own degree. Now, as I'm sure you can tell, computers run the world in more ways than one, so a computer engineering degree is really the place to be right now. If you want a job that pays well and lets you work for pretty much any company that's doing cool things right now, then definitely get a computer engineering degree. Some cool companies that you might work for are AMD, Intel, NVIDIA, and you can design GPUs and CPUs or literally any other computer hardware manufacturer like Samsung or Western Digital. There are so many options just within consumer electronics. And secondly, you could also work for a company like Apple, Dell, or Acer, or other hardware companies that put together the complete package and then sell it to consumers. You could also work for another category, such as microprocessor and embedded systems companies. And last but not least, you could end up working for a software company like Microsoft or Amazon, who want to integrate computer hardware into their systems. Your options are truly endless, and all of these companies will pay you a boatload of money. According to Michigan Tech, computer engineers not only have the highest starting salary of $75,000 of any engineering field, but they also have the highest average salary at $126,000 and the highest 10% salary at $192,000. So if your goal is to solely make the most amount of money, it's really a no-brainer. Software engineering, computer science, and computer engineering are the real money makers. I also want to take this moment to remind you that oftentimes the reason why engineers get paid so much is because of the city that they live in. If you're in a place like San Francisco or New York, your taxes and cost of living is going to be extremely high, so your income will automatically get cut in half and you'll be spending a lot of money just to rent out a place and pay for food. But that being said, if you're savvy with your finances, you can definitely make $126,000 go a very long way. And the second to last question is, will there be demand for computer engineers in the future? And the answer to this is simply yes. You don't even have to bother checking the answer, you just have to look around you. Sure, maybe 10 to 15 years from now, there might be more computer engineers than jobs available, but right now, it is a great time to be in the computer engineering field. And the truth is that 75% of people who do end up getting their engineering degree won't actually work in engineering, as per this video that I made, so if you're interested in that, be sure to check that out. It actually has some pretty interesting statistics. But if you are one of the people who wants to get an engineering job after completing their degree, there will almost certainly be a job for you as long as you have a little bit of that internship experience. So, should you take a computer engineering degree? As I've mentioned many times throughout this video, and after pointing out all of the positives, I have to say that absolutely, you should take a computer engineering degree if that's what you want to do. Computers are already such a big part of our lives, and they will only continue to take over the world, so getting a degree in computer engineering, in my opinion, is a very good choice. Thank you for watching this video. Let me know if you found it useful by leaving a comment down below. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this, and share it with a friend if you think they'll find it cool. Also, if you're trying to figure out what type of engineering is for you, check out this playlist that I'm making covering every single type of engineering field so that you can figure out which one would be best for you. Also, while you're at it, check out the description where I have links to some of my other channels. I talk about finance, I talk about magic mushrooms, so if you want to look at those things, please check that out. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.